Hey, what's up, everybody? Brian York here with Yorkie Moto Garage. We've got a special edition today. I just realized that about a year ago, I built this carburetor fan, and I don't think I ever showed you guys how I'm using it. So, anyway, we're building this carburetor for a 1970 CT70 HKO, and he wants to take the camera over here and show a picture of the bike. The bike's about 90% done. We're trying to finish it up, but we want to make sure that this carburetor has no leaks and make sure it's tuned and ready to go before we put it on the bike, because I really don't want any carburetor leaks on the bike. So what we've done is we've made this out of half inch pipe, and then I made this tank a long time ago. I welded it on here, and this is a piece of that. It's metal, and it's got slots in it. You just cut it out, and we zip tied it on there with some screws. And then we just bolt the carburetor and the intake on there. And I always just put a bowl here at the bottom of it, and then I always put a drain right here. What I do is, after I do these carburetors, I let them sit overnight and just make sure that they're not gonna leak. If there's any drops in there, then I gotta figure out what's going on with it and find out where the leaks are. Now, I haven't tried this. I just rebuilt this carburetor. I'm hoping that everything is good on it. I'm in the S position, which I don't know if that means, I think that means stop, and then there's a reserve, and then there's an on. So what I'm going to do now is turn this on in the on the S position. So far, I don't see any leaks anywhere. Now, so what we're going to do is we're going to put this in reserve, which I don't remember which one this is. One of them is reserve, and the other one is not. And we'll let it set for a second and see if any gas comes out of the carburetor after we open the petcock. So, just a couple seconds, let's open this up, see if there's any gas. No. Okay, so we're on the other side, so I'm going to bring this all the way down to the bottom here. And now we're going to let that set for a second or so. And we should start seeing some gas come out of this. Uh-oh. Looks like we've got a leak. Oh, it's coming out of this hose right here. That's fine. Sometimes my hoses leak a little bit. This is an old hose, so it's probably, as long as it leaks out there, we're good. I don't want it leaking out the carburetor anywhere. I usually just put a, all right, so let's open this up, see if there's anything coming out of here. Okay, I'm seeing a leak over here on this side where the packing is. So I'm gonna have to shut this off and redo this. Let's see, this is a good way to do this instead of having it on your bike and trying to do everything. These bikes are notorious for the carburetors leaking. And so what I'm gonna do, and I didn't see anything coming out of the carburetor, so we're gonna take this off here and see what's going on here and see if there's actually any gas in the carburetor at all. So give me just a second here and we will take this bowl off and see if there's any gas in there. Could be that this new float bowl is adjusted too high and it's shut off and it won't let it any gas go to it. Maybe we'll see if there's any fuel in there to begin with. Okay, look, there is no fuel. Okay, so what we're going to do is to test this to make sure that everything is unclogged. Well, I can't really do that because I got this off. So what we could do is take this here, and we can open this and see if any fuel comes out of here. I'm not seeing any. Oh, there it is. Yeah, we've got fuel coming out. So we know the fuel's getting here. Okay, so now I want to look at this float. This float is probably a little bit too high. There's a gauge. You can actually take the gauge and still got another issue. I got to fix the leak on this side over there, but this is a good way to do this. You can fix all this while you're, while you got it apart. And that way, I usually just do these floats by eye. This is a brand new float. See how high that is? It should be almost level. See how this is up too much? Let's push this down just a little bit. I'm gonna try to push that down a little bit. Floats a little bit out of adjustment. I'm gonna keep pushing this down until I get it the way I want it. Okay, you can adjust this piece right here. So let's put this back together now. And I'll show you once we do, oh, forgot the gasket. Once we do this, I'll show you that if it's adjusted correctly, the bowl should just be a little bit over half full. Everybody does it a little differently. This is the way I do it. It may not, I don't have a float, fancy float gauge like most people, but I do it the way that I do it, and it's always worked for me. A lot of people don't like the way I do things. That's the way we do it in this garage. I adjust it till I get it the way I want it. So what I'm gonna do here is we're gonna put this on here. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to tighten these screws up just a little bit more. Cause, oh, there we go. Now, oh, this one here is really loose. That's probably the culprit right there. Okay, well, let's put this back on here and we are going to try it again. And once we see fuel coming out of the bottom of this, we'll know that we're getting fuel to it, and then we'll let it set and then take the float bowl after we get fuel in it and see how much we got in the float bowl. If you got just a little bit, then it ain't enough. Gotta keep adjusting until we get the way we want it. Okay, so we got this tightened up. This is all tightened. We'll put this back on here and see what we get now. See what happens. And of course this little thing here is leaking. Might have to put a different hose on it. Okay, so let's open this up now and see if we get any fuel out of here. I'm not seeing any. It could have been on reserve too, so let me, I don't remember which one I got it on. See if it comes out here. Yeah, it looks like we're still gonna have to do some adjusting on this float. A lot of times you put new ones in there, it takes a while to get them all adjusted. All right, let's try it again. At least it's not leaking on this side anymore. Let's see here. Sometimes you gotta take the float out and just manually do it yourself. Takes a little bit of a while to get all this stuff adjusted correctly, but once you get adjusted correctly, usually bikes will run really good. This is an original carburetor. This is not a aftermarket, so yeah, it's still too high. So when this is open, this has got to be down farther. Let's stick my finger. I need to get a flat, little flathead screwdriver in there and push up on this little tab. Hold on just a second here. These carburetors are fickle. That's why nobody wants to mess with them. So we're going to put this under here like this, and then I'm going to push down on this tab a little bit. It's still too high. There we go. Now see how that brought that down a lot lower? That's probably gonna work now. So now, put this back together and we're just gonna keep adjusting it. And I'm not gonna bore you with this. I'm gonna do it a couple more times. If I don't get it, then I'll just have to send you another vid later of it finished. But this is how I do it. And then you can go back through and just kind of adjust it a little bit. Sometimes it takes an hour for me to get it adjusted properly. If I had the gauge, I could probably adjust it in a few minutes, but I'm too cheap to pay $75 or $100 for a gauge. A lot of times people say they're not very good. So I don't really rely on that stuff. I've done these carburetors for 20 years and I haven't had no problems too much. So I'm just going to put one screw back in at this time. Put this back on. But once we get everything adjusted, like I said, I'll sit this overnight and then drain this thing out. I got gas everywhere, didn't I? Okay, here we go again. So we're going to open this back up. I'm going to go all the way down because I think it needs to be in the downward position. Open her up so we're getting more fuel coming out of it. Nope. There we go. Yeah. Now we got it. Okay. Now we got fuel coming out. And we're going to shut this and we're going to make sure that this thing don't over. What will happen now is this carb is going to fill up. And if it gets up to the point to where it fills up properly, then it'll stop. If not, it'll start overflowing right here, and then we'll have to take it back apart and readjust it back down a little bit. Still going to leak from this hose. I wish I'd have put a different hose on it, but y'all get the picture of it. Anyway, this is an original K-Hen carb, completely redone. I vapor blasted it, and then we put a new carb kit in it, and I think it looks pretty nice. I mean the customer will love it. I'll tell you what, it looks like it's leaking out here, but it's not leaking up here. So it takes just, I don't know, maybe a it's not leaking here, it's not leaking here. That's the main thing. I can take this hose up. This is just temporary hose to block this hole right here. All that is. Okay, so I'm going to shut this off, and we're going to take the carburetor apart carefully and hold the bowl and see how much fuel is in that bowl. If you only got a half a bowl or less, then you don't have enough. You're going to have to adjust that. A lot of people, they adjust these carburetors, and they get them too far off, and then they only have like a quarter of gas in them. And then they don't run right because there's not enough fuel in there, starving the bike out. This is the way I figure out how much fuel's in a carburetor. Oh my gosh, look at that. That is just like almost perfect. Wow, that is awesome. So what I'm going to do now is I am going to put this carburetor back together. I'm going to leave the fuel in this. I'm going to put a different hose on here because that was leaking. I don't want the hose to leak because I want to be able to make sure that the carburetor is not leaking. It's just the stinking. We're going to clean this all up, dry it up. And then once it gets all dried up, then we are going to let it sit overnight and just let it sit here and make sure that there's nothing. And then when I go to put this bike to get back together, a lot of people ask me what kind of gas we use in these carburetors. Gas you want to use in this carburetor is a non-ethanol Rec 90. And even if it's an older bike, it's okay for these carburetors. What that does, you use a Rec 90, or what's even better, and you might have to adjust the mixture a little bit on the air, is airplane fuel. Use the lowest grade airplane fuel they have, and then that stuff lasts a long time. It doesn't tarnish. The only thing about using regular 87 gas, these carburetors don't have a lot of, they're not sealed really good. So if you let them set with fuel in them for a week or two, it'll turn brown, and your bike won't start if this gas turns brown in that carburetor. So what I'm gonna do, and I'm not gonna show you this, I don't wanna bore you with it, I'm gonna change this hose on here, and we'll let this set overnight. And if this thing is completely drained and there's no gas in it and it's dry in the morning, and it's still got fuel in this carburetor, then this carburetor is good to go. And all we have to do is put it on this bike here and get everything adjusted in, and I'll get this to the client that wants this bike. But I just wanted to show you all how this works. And if you wanna build one, you can go look at my other video on how I do it. It's basically just a bunch of parts that I bought at Menards. Menards is a cheap place to buy these pipe parts. And you can build it, you know, taller or shorter. Get you a plastic lawnmower tank. I also have I also have some other tanks, which they should be hanging here. I don't know what I've done with them. All right, here's one. You can take these tanks and make you a hook on top and put one of these on there. One thing I don't like is these things here leak. If you find your really good tank, or you can put your lawnmower tank mount on, you can get really, you get some stuff that's laying around the house, just make you a stand like what I got. It don't have to be elaborate like mine. I think I spent 45 or 50 bucks building that one. To me, it was well worth it because I use this every day when I'm building carburetors for different bikes. So anyway, I just wanted to show you this, and I hope you it was a good video for you. And like and subscribe to my page. Thank you all for showing up on Yorkie Motor today, and we'll see you.